Good morning, Monday Clubbers. Tony here, after a week away in Wales, lovely Wales. It was lovely, but it was very wet. So, here we are on week 22 of confusing COVID. Hope you're all well and rested from the intense watercolour action. So now I'm holding the camera by hand, looking at a familiar sight. It's Whitby Abbey, of course. Here after a snowfall. This is from a photograph by Bev Cappelman. It's a lovely photograph. So we're going to paint this. And we'll... I'll move the Abbey to one side a little bit. And just raise it to about a third. Add some colour to the Abbey. It's looking a bit sombre there, and in actual fact it's a lovely pale sandstone colour. So I'll use raw sienna and burnt umber mix for the stonework. So it'll have a bit of a glow about it from the sun, which will come from the left hand side. Keep the colours in the sky the same, fairly cool colours will look good against the Abbey. There'll be a reflection in the water. We've moved over to the right so that this little ruin here will disappear. Which is good, I didn't like it there anyway. So, I'll put you into the familiar position. Don't be awkward. That's it. Right. So I think you can see the paper and my palette nicely there. That's the bottom of the paper. Okay. So I've drawn it in, as usual. I'll start with the Abbey, and as I said, raw sienna and burnt umber. I should have wet this paint more. On the photograph, you may have seen there's lots of snow gathered on the stonework. I'm going to ignore that. I don't want it to look twee. I started with the Abbey rather than the sky because I'll be painting around it with the sky, so as not to spoil this colour. You can't see through these side windows, so I can just paint them in. I can't see that either, so I'll paint it all in now. So I can go right through, darken that a little. Because the full sun will be from the left. This is pale. This This is a bit darker. Okay, that's a start. I'll come back to adding a bit more detail here and there later. But that's good for now, so I'll let that dry a little. Okay, that's dry now, so I'll start with the sky using some existing paint on my palette. Looks okay. Add a bit of French ultramarine. Let's see how this looks. That's alright. Warmed it up a little with some yellow ochre. More water. Water. I'm just going to dab a few windows on this, windows of light. Just soften that edge a bit. So carry on. Very watery. Yellow ochre, or Naples yellow. Just a tad here and there. Right, the sky gets more dramatic now, so French ultramarine, Payne's grey. Fairly liberal application. It will slowly seep southwards. So again, I'm softening that edge. Yellow ochre. So 99% water. I'm attacking this fairly randomly. Okay. There's a line across there which I let dry, softening that up. Okay. So, a bit of pale blue, showing its face through here and there. And a diagonal line across. That dry a little, so it's dry but not bone dry now, so I'm gonna come back with some more dark. Dark clouds. Because it's damp, it's still got some nice soft edges, but over here it's dried almost fully, so I can put some sharper detail in. It's a bit of a lottery to know what is dry and what isn't, but that's okay, I like that. Gonna add a bit of burnt umber. Just an extra element in the clouds. Dry brush that across, not too much. So the clouds in the distance and more in layers, because of the effect of perspective. But those layers fizzle out on this side. Fairly haphazard brushwork. Okay. I'll let this dry and then I'll have a think about it. Okay. Now I turned you off instead of pausing, so I don't know how I'm going to resolve that, but I'm going to carry on steadfastly, switching to the around the landscape now. Distant tree line. It's darker as it gets closer. Individual trees become evident. More dark, more contrast. On this side, these are distant moorlands, so just a plain grey colour. Okay, so that's brought us right to the front of the abbey. I'll just give that extremely pale blue. Run that right through. Now the water is fringed with the depression that it sits in. Some gaps in it. And the water itself, generally the same colour as the sky, so perhaps a bit greyer. So this will be pale ultramarine and Payne's grey. That looks okay. Fairly plain. The gap in the middle is the reflection of the abbey. graduate that a little. This is a bit of disruption caused by wind. Now the Abbey reflection. It's dark. You can stop there. Because we're right up against the near shoreline. Some darker blue run into this. This front is looking a bit deep, so I might crop that off. I'll carry on. Fairly dark reeds. Fairly red in colour. Right, I'm employing my old reed making brush. just a rough old, I don't know what it is, hog hair, kiddie's brush. Okay, enough. Okay. Giving the snow some presence. Okay, coming back to the Abbey now. So, burnt umber, because that's still wet. Need to bridge it with a little rest. There we go. So I'm just tidying up the detail on the Abbey. Don't have to do it all, just here and there. Perfectly dry now, so it will take a nice crisp line. These arches should be in line. Although I'm not going to do a lot of detail. It's not necessary. Just a hint. Turn it back a bit. This does made a line that. I'll do that again. A couple of birds have appeared in the sky. I'm thinking that's okay. I should probably crop it off about there. Try and wash that out. Okay. It's looking all right. Just darken that sky a bit. I'm quiet because I don't know if I'm going to be able to make a movie of this. It might have to be 2-3 separate movies. Anyway, I'm messing with it now. Putting in things that aren't necessarily there, I just think it needs them. I'm going to try and create a flat area there, but it won't have it. This paper just soaks the paint right in, you can't get it out. So, it's okay. Right, Whitby Abbey, in the snow, almost finished. Just make the water look a bit more like water. Give a dark heart to these reeds. I'm just doing what I tell the class not to do. Stop messing with it. It's not getting any better. See? See what I mean? It's no better, is it? Right, done. Okay, see you next week. Bye now.